Nursemaid's elbow or pulled elbow. The elbow is made up of the upper arm bone, humerus, and the two bones in the forearm, radius, and ulna. Annular ligament runs around the radial head and holds it against the ulna, and permits for free rotation of radial head as its internal surface is lined with cartilage. Nursemaid's elbow is a common injury among children under the age of 5. It is a result of the radius bone becoming partially dislocated, slipping out of its normal position in the annular ligament at the elbow joint when a child's elbow is suddenly pulled. Nursemaid's elbow is a common injury of early childhood because a young child's ligaments are loose and not fully formed. Even a mild force on the joint may cause the head of the radius to slip under the annular ligament. As children age, the annular ligament thickens and nursemaid's elbow becomes less likely to occur. Causes. Nursemaid's elbow often occurs when you hold a child's hand or wrist and pulls suddenly on the arm. It may also occur during play when you swing a child around holding just the arms or hands. Nursemaid's elbow is rarely caused by a fall. If a child injures the elbow when falling onto an outstretched hand or directly onto the elbow, it may be a broken bone rather than nursemaid's elbow. Symptoms. Child refuses to use the affected limb and holds the elbow in slight flexion and the forearm pronated, with pain and tenderness localized to the lateral aspect of the elbow. You may feel a click in the elbow at the time of the injury. Do not try to move your child's arm and never attempt to relocate a pulled elbow by yourself because you may harm the child. You should bring your child to the doctor right away. The doctor is able to tell if your child has nursemaid's elbow by asking about the injury and doing a physical examination. Imaging may be useful when diagnostic challenges occur with atypical presentations or unknown history. Your doctor will order an X-ray if he thinks the injury caused a broken bone. Treatment. When the doctor is certain there are no fractures, he will fix the dislocation by rotating the forearm so that the palm faces upward and gently flexing the elbow with applying pressure over the radial head. Or by hyperpronating of the forearm, rotating the forearm so that the palm faces downward, while in the flexed position with gently pressure over the radial head. Often, the doctor will feel a click in the elbow when the radial head pops back into place. This procedure is called closed reduction of the dislocation. This procedure is painful and distressing, but it is very quick. After this procedure, your child will probably not need any further treatment. Your child will be observed for a short while to check that they are using their arm without any problems or pain. Your child will feel much better and may be able to use his arm normally 5 to 10 minutes after the reduction. Operative open reduction rarely required indications for chronic, symptomatic subluxations that cannot be reduced. It is important for you to understand that nursemaid's elbow will not cause any long-term damage to your child. But once it has occurred, there is a high likelihood of recurrence, especially if the child is younger than 3 years. For this reason, as well as to prevent an initial occurrence, do not pull hard on your child's arm or lift him or her up by the hand, wrist, or forearm. Instead, lift your child up, hold him or her by the upper arms or under the arms. When recurrence occurs, treatment will be with cast application in flexion and neutral or supination.